Today I'm going to show you how I teach solar system to my students. I have a big rug and that is my universe. And as you can see, these lines are the orbits. And I have models of the planets, and these can be easily done by taking styrofoam balls or tennis balls, and they can be painted with, you can use spray paint or any other paint closest to the color of the planets. My planets are, the numbers are all there, so it's easier for the children to place them on the right orbit. And I have label cards too that will match with the planets. The first thing that I talk about is the sun. The sun is in the middle of the solar system. The sun is a star, so that's where the sun goes. The next planet closest to the sun is Mercury. That's the first planet. And number one, Mercury. And as you can see, each planet has its own orbit or its path. So they always travel around the sun in their own orbit. If they did not have a path, the planets would crash into each other. My first planet closest to the sun is Mercury. My next planet closest to the sun is going to be Venus. That's my next planet. Mercury in the daytime is very, very hot because it's so close to the sun, whereas at the nighttime it really cools down. And Venus is, has a lot of clouds. Now the third planet closest to the sun is the Earth. And do we live on Earth? Yes, we do. So Earth is the only living planet. So this is Earth, and it's number three. The fourth planet closest to the sun is Mars. Mars is often called the red planet. Now the first four planets are the inner planets: Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars. The next planet is called Jupiter, and Jupiter is the largest planet in the solar system. So this is Jupiter. The next planet is Saturn, number six. And Saturn is a beautiful planet. It has lots of rings around it, and these rings are made out of dust and ice. So Saturn. The next planet is Uranus, the seventh planet. This is Uranus. And the eighth planet is Neptune. Neptune is almost always called the blue planet. Now these four planets, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, are the gassy giants. They are the big planets. Now I have a last line here, the orbit, because at one time Pluto was a planet. So that's why we have this here, but right now the scientists think that Pluto is not a planet anymore. Now I have some rocks here. These rocks are asteroids. In our universe we have asteroids. And asteroids can be big, big chunks of rocks. Some of them can be as big as a house. And I'm just going to just spread my asteroids back here. And now I'm going to match my labels. And as I said, they are numbered, so that helps me. Only the one that is not numbered is the sun. Remember, the sun is in the middle of the solar system. The sun is a star. The sun doesn't move, but all the planets go around the sun. So the first planet closest to the sun is Mercury, number one. The next planet closest to the sun is Venus, number two. The third planet closest to the sun is Earth. Earth is our planet. We live on Earth. That's the only living planet. The next planet closest to the sun is Mars, the red planet. The next planet closest to the sun will be Jupiter. That's the largest planet in the solar system. The next will be Saturn. The next will be Uranus. And the last will be Neptune. So these are the planets of our solar system. I also have a paper that goes with my work, and the students love to color this paper and take it home. This is how I teach solar system to my students. Hope that helped.